Hi, I'm Pete Duck, Senior Relationship Manager at EDF. Welcome to the University of Wales Trinity St David. Energy is changing in the education sector. We're here to find out how. Hi Dan, how you doing? You okay?
Yeah, good thanks, nice to see you again. Should we go and have a look around?
We're talking, of course, about solar energy. EDF have been working with the university and TEC, and today we're excited to share that story.
So a few months ago, this was just an idea, and now we're running on solar.
Absolutely fantastic. So thanks all for coming. Dan, do you want to tell us how we achieved this solar project?
Well, in national surveys, students say it's important to them to study at a university that's committed to sustainability. We wanted to look at alternative ways to power our campuses. We'd done the quick wins, but the problem is buildings like this are in built-up areas, so that rules out wind turbines. But we could go solar, so long as we could retrofit to our rooftops. That's where the TEC framework came in, with a quick and easy route to procurement.
So Paula, why is this good for the education sector?
Energy prices where they are, the business case for the installation of solar PV system makes sense. Not only is it cost efficient, but it supports their net zero journey. The first step is probably the most difficult. There's so many suppliers, it can be really confusing.
So that's when we all met at the TEC member event, talking about the TEC framework and its solar offering. Paula, do you want to tell us more?
TEC is owned by its members, so our framework is designed around what they need. We offer a simple, compliant route to market, saving time, cost and effort of procurement. We really do make that first step easy.
So Dan, as a member of the TEC framework, how did it help you make those first steps?
TEC had a proven process, and EDF put their name to it, meaning we were dealing with a trusted and reliable energy partner. We quickly went from initial conversation to contract to our first retrofit solar generation up and working.
So Dylan, tell us, what's it powering?
It's powering the Deneva building, which is one of our larger buildings. And because of the nature of the programmes within it, it has a high energy consumption. But we believe that we're allowing our students to follow those practical programmes in a sustainable way.
Dan, this is the first project of its kind for the university. What does the future hold?
Well, it gives us something to point to say, look, imagine what we can do with TEC and EDF looking at new and exciting ways to power our campuses. This is just the start.
Dylan, you're training the next generation to lead and build a sustainable world. How does that make you feel?
It makes us feel very proud. The road to net zero is full of uncertainties, but we're convinced that the answer to those uncertainties lies within our student body. We believe that we're allowing our students to leave a legacy, which is a more sustainable world.
Well, thanks all, that's great insight, and I look forward to following your journey to net zero.
My generation appreciate being able to work and study inside an energy efficient building because it means that our future is looking brighter each day.
So it's one thing just putting out statements saying you're environmentally friendly, but actually putting investment into solar energy, that takes real commitment.